Dale, I guess a few years back you wouldn't have seen too many lobster boats with game fishing chairs on them.
No, not too many, but when this fishery started and they put put tuna into industry, all you needed to do to get a license was put a chair in and buy a rod.
And buy a rod.
And you had a license. And that's how all the licenses were invented around here.
Because I noticed that it's only lobster boats that have got the chairs in them, so you had to be an established commercial fisherman.
Yes.
So recreational anglers can't come up here, set up their own boat and come out here and catch these tuna.
No, it's a strictly byproduct of a commercial fishery, which means that doctors, lawyers, rich guys, only way they can get into it is put their 2 years in commercial fishing, buy the license and do what we did.
And that's because it's such a precious fish, and I think everyone knows that the Atlantic bluefin tuna, you hear about them being endangered all the time. I guess it's got to be regulated, and the only way to regulate it is to go through a commercial fishery, because I've heard you guys talking, and if I got this right, you've got to have a tag, a special tag that you can put into a fish before you're allowed to take it, and you're only allowed one fish per boat per year, is that right?
Lately it's been like that.
And so obviously now, I mean, with the numbers of fish, it's obviously working.
It's working for the simple reason we've always been rod and reel.
Hook and line.
Hook and line. That's always been a sport to me.
So I guess, I mean, if you're only taking one fish a year, you're out here, you're doing catch and release fishing, you've got people coming from all over the world, yet you're only taking one fish.
That's it.
Now that to me is a very good use of a resource. You know, they've managed it like this, they've restricted the numbers, and yet they're making more money and they've got more work from killing only one fish, and that's a real good balance between commercial and sport fishing take.
We're making the economy grow.
And not only is the economy growing, but the fishery's growing. So it just goes to show you, you don't need to slaughter every fish out there to make a fishery work. Beautiful, there you go. Roe.
Sweet.
Man, that's beautiful. It really is good. And the commercial fishery, it's all about them catching this herring for that row.
Yeah.
That's the high value part of the fish.
Nothing's wasted.
Yo, here's it, there he is. He's right here.